Hello villagers, in this video I want to show you how I finally found and invite Raymond, the most wanted Raymond that everyone wanted to see, to finally move in to my island. Before we go to that part of story, I want to tell you about me and my channel here. Actually, I'm not a full-time gamer in my life. In real life, I'm an architect and a designer. And why I make this channel at the first place is because I love to play games in my free time. And now, with the coronavirus still terrorizing our neighborhood, I spend a lot of time at home. And this Animal Crossing really filled my free time and keep me happy. And also, I really love to share about what I'm doing for fun. And I really happy if it can entertain everyone and keep me productive and be positive. So that's why this channel is up and running. So maybe in the future I would make some more videos about what game I played before fun with my console or my phone. Maybe not only this Animal Crossing, or maybe this Animal Crossing New Horizons would still be the main course of this channel if you all want it. So if you have any suggestion for me or other game that I should try or not to try, or even want me to stay focused only for this game, just leave a comment below. And also, after my previous video, I want to show you that finally I have managed to fill my bank in this game with more than 100 million bells, guys. You can see it here. This is because of that guide in my previous video. If you haven't checked it before, you can see the link above here. And also, yesterday after that guide, I also managed to optimize the trick even more efficient. So like and subscribe my channel if you want to keep updated and get notified if I posted something new in the future. So before we start talking about Raymond, let's roll the intro. So first thing to remember, this guide are using time traveling method. So if time traveling is not your thing, maybe this guide is not for you. But I can say that this method actually really possible to do without time traveling, and time traveling is only meant to speed up the process. So actually, when I finally found this Raymond was really by accident, because actually I was in the process to get rid one of my villager so I could run for the mystery island method for finding Raymond later. But after some time traveling almost 1 month ahead, I still got no villager with bubble speeds. And when I see the announcement of the day from Isabel that someone is actually come to the campsite, I run to the campsite and surprisingly found this really the most wanted smug cat Raymond. And wow, I jumped and start wondering what I've done before. This must be not a miracle from nowhere. It must be something that I've done before that really make this happening. So after that, I just realized that unintentionally the campsite method works for me. So at the time of my time traveling to find that bubble switch villagers, I realized that I have no villagers with smoke personality in my island, and only have one cat species, that is Olivia, which is not a smoke personality. She is a snooty cat villager. As you can see here, these are all my villagers before I found Raymond at the campsite. Actually, I'm sorry that I forgot to record my island map before Olivia moved out, so here it is. Here I have Phoebe, the sisterly villager. I have Lobo and Apollo, the cranky villagers. I have Mitch, a Midge, or whatever it is, the normal personality villager. I have Roll for joke personality. I have Walker and Wade for lazy personality. I have Ruby for peppy villager. And I have Whitney and Olivia for the snooty villager. And as you can see, I have no smug personality villager in my island. And so in this condition, I have greater possibility to meet smug personality in the campsite. Even if I already have the full 10 villager in my island, my possibility to find smug camper was increased. Some people say that you may found that missing personalities in your island for around 60% at the campsite. And if we calculate it to find the smug cat Raymond is 60% by 134 of all smug villagers that available in the game. And actually this calculation discovered and shared by Sina from Animal Crossing New Horizon Indonesian Discord community and Dr. Jace Anatomy from Reddit community for these discoveries. So shout out to them and thank you for these big discoveries, guys. So here it is, the method, the campsite method. First, prepare your wanted personality. Make sure that you don't have this personality in your island. Replace them if you already have the same personality for it by using the time traveling method for Bubble Speed Villager or using the Amiibo card for the easiest way. After you've done that, make note when is the last camper came to your island. And the next step is go straight 6 days forward after that last day camper came to your island. And why 6 days? This 6 days is when the possibilities of the new camper come to your island is become maximum, increased by around 20%. And after that, if you still haven't found a new camper, quit your game again, then go forward for 1 day until you found a new camper in your island from Isabel's announcement. And if you have found a new camper, go check that camper. If it's not who you are looking for, go ahead and move forward for 6 days from there. Repeat it until you found who you are looking for. And that's it. And the last thing, please don't forget to actually invite the camper to move into your island. You need to really make a good attention of their conversation and win the mini games to win their heart. As you can see here in my video, that Raymond actually give me a mini game to win his heart. This is the beginning of the conversation. And then you ask him to move in. And he wants you to convince him why he must move in to your island. And he gave you a mini game or a puzzle. And if your answer is correct, he will agree to move to your island. And after that, he will ask you about which villagers that he will replace, and you just need to agree, because in my case, I cannot choose which one that he will replace. And then, all good, you're ready to go. So that's all that I have managed to discover from my encounter with the smoke cat Raymond, and finally I have successfully invited him to live in my island. So guys, if you wanted to get more guides or tricks or more exciting information about this Animal Crossing New Horizon or even other game, click the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel to keep you updated when I post more video or content. So thank you guys for watching, and see you, villager.